Hello everyone, I am Dr. Meenakshi Rana, working as an academic consultant in the Department of Physics, Uttarakhand Open University, Haldwani. My video lecture presentation is on crystal structure. In this, I will discuss the basic terminology used in crystal structure that will help you to understand the crystal structure and solid state physics easily. Now, the content of my video lecture. I will discuss about the crystallines and amorphous solid, the crystal structure. In this, I will discuss about the basic terminology as lattice translation vector, primitive vector, a basis, unit cell and primitive cells, and different types of lattices in two-dimensional crystal system and in three-dimensional type crystal system. Now, the learning outcome. After studying this video lecture, you should be able to define the crystalline and amorphous solid and can understand the different terminology used in crystal structure such as crystal structure, lattice, lattice translation vector, primitive vector, basis, Breweis lattice, unit cell and primitive cells, and can also understand the different types of lattices in 2 and 3 dimensions. As we all know that we can divide the solid in two parts as crystalline solid and amorphous solid. In case of crystalline solid, there is a regular repetition of atoms or molecule in three-dimensional periodic array. The examples of the crystalline solids are sodium chloride, diamond, snowflakes, metals, ice, ceramics, etc. In amorphous solids, the materials in which the constituents such as atoms or molecules are not arranged in a regular manner over a long range, there is no periodicity in the structure. The examples of the amorphous type solids are glass, plastic, rubbers, etc. Here are the figure shown for the crystalline solid where there is the periodic arrangement of the atoms or molecules, and this figure shows the amorphous solid where there is no periodic arrangement of atoms or molecules. Now, we can also classify the crystalline solids in two parts, at the single crystalline and in the polycrystalline. In case of the single crystalline, the periodicity of the atoms or molecules is over the whole volume, and diamond is the good example of this single crystalline type solid. While in case of polycrystalline, there is a breaking of some types of grains where the periodicity is arranged, but in the whole crystals the periodicity is not formed. So in this case, the periodicity is divided in different types of grain boundaries where there is then periodic arrangement of atoms. The examples of polycrystallines are Fe, aluminium, gold, Ag, etc., where we have already studied about this amorphous solid where there is no periodic arrangement of atoms. Now we will discuss about the lattice. Basically, an periodic arrangement of imaginary point in space as shown in this figure is known as lattice. Okay, now there is a concept of ideal lattice. An ideal lattice is any lattice having infinite length or no endpoints is known as ideal lattice. Now, what is a basis? Basically, basis in an atom or group of atom is known as basis. It may be monoatomic or may be diatomic. Now, what is a crystal structure? Basically, crystal structure is the formation occurs when there is a lattice plus basis. Means lattice plus basic form a crystal structure. Here is the symbol of lattice, and where there is a monoatomic basis when this basis attached to the lattice. In this type, means here the lattice is there and each monatomic base is attached to the lattice, this forms an crystal. And the number of atoms in the bases may vary. Okay, this again shows where this is a lattice and this is a basis. Here there is a monoatomic basis and this forms a crystal. Similarly, in this case, this is a lattice and here is a diatomic basis and this also forms a lattice. So the number of atoms in bases may vary. There is no restriction in this. So a crystal is a combination of a lattice and a basis. Now, what is a unit cell? Unit cell is defined as a smallest unit of lattice or a crystal which on continuous repetition can generate the whole lattice or the crystal. Now, what is a lattice parameter? Lattice parameter basically defined by A, B and C, and lattice parameters is basically the distance between any two lattice points, or we can say the lattice parameters defined as the distance between two consecutive lattice points. Here these are two consecutive lattice points and the distance between them, two consecutive lattice points, is A. So A is defined as a lattice parameter, also known as lattice constant. Here the distance between these two lattice points is B. So B is also known as the lattice parameter or lattice constant. Here these vector A and vector B are also known as lattice translation vector. Now we will discuss about the Bravais lattice. Bravais lattice are those lattice in which each lattice point has identical surrounding. Okay, means each lattice point have a same type of surrounding. Suppose if we choose this point and this point have the same, this, each have the same surrounding. So these type of lattice point is known as Bravais lattice. Now we will discuss about different types of lattice, such as the simple cubic lattice, and it is denoted by capital P. In this, the atoms will be situated at the corners as shown in this figure. The atoms are only in the corner of the cube. So this is called as a simple cubic lattice. In the body center cubic lattice, it is denoted by BCC or capital I. Here the atoms are at the corner of the body, simple cubic body, and at the center of the cube. In the face centered cubics, it is denoted by FCC or capital F. In this case, the atoms are at the corner as shown in this figure and at the center of each faces. Now the primitive lattice. Primitive lattice are those lattice in which the effective number of atoms is 1. Effective number of atoms are those which are completely within the lattice. Now the end centered or base centered cubic. It is denoted by capital C, and in this type of system we have the atoms at the corners of the cubic cell and any one pair of opposite faces as shown in this figure. Now the different types of crystal system in two dimension. We have basically four types of crystal system in two dimension. They are square type, rectangular, hexagonal and oblique type of crystal system. Now we will discuss in detail these type of crystal system and their Bravais lattice. Corresponding these four type of crystal system in 2D, we have five type of Bravais lattice. For square type of crystal system, we have simple square type of Bravais lattice. For these, conditions of lattice constants and the angle between them are A equal to B and gamma equal to 90 degree, where A and B are the lattice constant or lattice translation vector and gamma is the angle between A and B. For rectangular type of crystal system, we have two type of Bravais lattice as primitive rectangular and centered rectangular. And the condition for these are A does not equal to B and gamma equal to 90 degree. For hexagonal type of crystal system, we have simple hexagonal type of Bravais lattice and condition for this is A equal to B and gamma equal to 120 degree. For oblique type of crystal system, we have simple oblique type of Bravais lattice and the condition for this is A does not equal to B and gamma does not equal to 90 degree. Now, the crystal system in 3 dimension, we have these type of crystal systems in 3 dimension and corresponding to them, we have 14 type of Bravais lattice. Now, we will discuss them in detail. For cubic type of crystal system, we have 3 types of Bravais lattice as simple cubic, body centered and face centered. For these, their lattice parameter conditions are A1 equal to A2 equal to A3 and alpha equal to beta equal to gamma equal to 90 degree, where alpha is the angle between A1 and A2, beta is the angle between A2 and A3 and gamma is the angle between A3 and A1 lattice parameters. Here is the examples of these type of crystal system. Now the tetragonal type of crystal system have 2 types of Bravais lattice, simple tetragonal and body centered tetragonal. And the condition for these type of crystal systems are A1 equal to A2 but not equal to A3 and alpha equal to beta equal to gamma equal to 90 degree Celsius. 90 degree. And the examples of these are given them. Now the orthorhombic. For orthorhombic type of crystal system, we have 4 type of Bravais lattice as simple, body centered, face centered and end centered. And the condition is A1 does not equal to A2, does not equal to A3 and alpha equal to beta equal to gamma equal to 90 degree. And the examples are these. For monoclinic type of crystal system, we have 2 types of lattice type. Means we have 2 types of Bravais lattice as simple and end centers. And the conditions are A1 does not equal to A2, does not equal to A3 and alpha equal to gamma equal to 90 degree and not equal to beta. Now the triclinic type of crystal system, we have simple type of Bravais lattice for this case and condition for this is A1 does not equal to A2, does not equal to A3 and alpha does not equal to beta, does not equal to gamma. And the examples of this is, now the trigonal, it is also called rhombohedral and for this case the lattice, Bravais lattice is simple type. And the condition is alpha equal to beta equal to gamma less than 120 degree but not equal to 90 degree. And A1 equal to A2 equal to A3. The examples are given. For hexagonal type of crystal system, we have simple type of Bravais lattice. And the condition is alpha equal to beta equal to 90 and gamma equal to 120 degree. And A1 equal to A2 but not equal to A3. And the examples are given. I hope you have understood the basic terminology used in crystal structure and this will help you to understand the crystal structures easily. Thank you so much.